According to the U.S. Census Bureau, women make up 27% of STEM careers in the United States, despite providing half of the workforce. Showing girls and young women examples of women succeeding in these jobs can help light the way for more to pursue math, science, and engineering. Today, California's Department of Water Resources held a workshop dedicated to women in science, featuring a panel of female leaders from several different state agencies.
I think if you can't see someone like you in a position that you might want, it doesn't even exist in your subconscious as an option.
Dr. Louise Conrad is lead scientist for California's Department of Water Resources. Her expertise helps to guide the organization as it navigates the challenges of climate change and other threats to the state's natural resources. She credits her mother, a physician, for paving the way for her success in a male-dominated field. Now, she and other female science leaders are helping to do the same.
At DWR, we are very fortunate and lucky to have many leaders in science, many leaders out of our organization that are women.
Leaders from several state agencies gathered at the Natural Resources Building today to share ideas on communicating their sciences in a way that's inclusive. Flood planning, cultural resources, conservation, and building relationships with farming communities were all discussed, as well as ways that women can bring their own unique skills to work on those issues.
Just seeing a small group of them together was really representative of what I know is a very large workforce of women that are working to be communicators and scientists at our natural resource agencies.
As part of the program, Dale Hoffman Florkey was presented with the inaugural Sierra Nevada Phillips Award for Women in Water Resource Sciences, recognizing her leadership and mentorship within her many roles, including an executive role with DWR, where she set a tone for hiring people of all backgrounds.
To me, you have to treat everybody equally. There's no reason why engineers who are working alongside environmental scientists, women or men, doesn't matter, they're doing the same work, they should be paid equally, and they should be treated equally.
And Dr. Conrad says there is still a lot of work to be done across all science fields to ensure that women of all backgrounds are given the opportunities and the resources to succeed. DWR is also planning a lot of outreach programs to help reach school-age children as well.
I love seeing this. As you know, my mom's a biologist, and you know, early in her career, she was actively discouraged. She had professors who said it's a waste of time because you're just going to get married and have kids, you know, which she did, get married and have kids and had an amazing career. So I've certainly seen the benefits of encouragement and how far this has come.
I have the same experience with my own mom. She works in the engineering field.
Yeah.
Hey, the door is open now.
Yes.
It's not going to shut.
So different.
All right.